Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Well, the sun today and the dry winds really helped us out, helped dry out those roadways during the day today, and we're not getting any additional snow now. Just a couple flurries being picked up out towards Altoona and State College on the live Super Doppler 8 radar network. It looks like it's going to be quiet this evening and pretty much all the way through most of the weekend as well. So holiday shoppers will have no problems from Mother Nature, it doesn't look like at this point. Officially outside, 30 degrees and a wind chill of 25. The wind's only at 5 miles per hour right now, so not all that brisk or that cold. Certainly not as blustery as it was on Monday and Tuesday. And temperatures are kind of tolerable, I might say. 32 degrees in Reading, 31 in Westchester, the Red Rose City coming in at 29, about 26 degrees in Lewistown. And again, the temperatures aren't that far away from the wind chills because there's not that much wind out there. We had a couple flurries across the north earlier today, and there's still, you know, kind of a cold flow coming over the Great Lakes, just bringing a couple of snow showers, especially across New England today, but we're not getting a whole lot, and a lot of this will be tapering off as we go through the rest of the evening. And there's a little bit of precipitation down in the southeast, down towards Arkansas and northern Louisiana, moving to parts of western Tennessee. There is still going to be a storm system that's going to be moving to the southeast over the weekend. But all the latest computer guidance is for this to be too far to the east to affect us out of anything more than some cloud cover. So we'll put our predictor into motion here. The westerly winds will continue, so the clear skies continue to move in during the nighttime hours. Some high-level clouds start to move over us during the afternoon tomorrow as this storm system starts to take shape. But again, most of the activity, if not all of it, is going to be too far to the east of us. It does turn into a pretty potent storm as it curves up to the north, but notice it looks like, and of course, a lot of the runs, a lot of the computers had it right along the coast yesterday, so we're still keeping an eye on it. But it looks like it may curve all the way up towards far eastern New England by the time Monday rolls around, and we just end up getting kind of a gusty northwesterly wind again Sunday into Monday. Temperature-wise, temperatures will remain below average all weekend. We're going to be dropping down into the teens overnight tonight. We won't see as many single digits because we got rid of a lot of that snow that was on the ground to start out the day today, but we're back up into the lower 30s again for afternoon highs tomorrow. Looks like we'll be right around 20 degrees again tomorrow night, and then as Sunday rolls around, probably also once again in the low 30s. So looking like this throughout the weekend, officially we'll say 34 tomorrow and on Sunday, partly sunny skies tomorrow, mostly cloudy on Sunday. The storm system will be close enough to bring us clouds and maybe some flurries. We'll keep an eye on it still tomorrow, but we think it's going to miss us to the east now. Monday looks like a quiet day, 32. Then as we head towards Tuesday and Wednesday of next week, there'll be another fast-moving but weak system. That has a chance to bring us some light snow or some flurries. But then behind that, windy, blustery, cold conditions on Wednesday and Thursday all over again. Still no warm temperatures in that 70s.